So, Nick, how do you see the Dodgers putting an end to this slide?
Yeah, well, I mean, let's be honest. The bullpen isn't as good as they were last year. Starting pitching hasn't been as good as they were last year. And this is the first time in the last 4 years that your Dodgers have had to battle for the division title. We're definitely going to see what they're made of. I think the biggest thing that they're missing right now is that one consistent piece. Last year, it was Cody Bellinger. He came up and hit all year long. Now you had guys like Matt Kemp, Max Muncy, who really got off some hot starts. Obviously, they've kind of come back down to earth a little bit. And now I just feel like there's a lot of inconsistencies in their lineup. I mean, I wouldn't even know what to change. I mean, I know you would switch up a few things.
The lineup has been very inconsistent. They're too talented to be this inconsistent. They have a very deep lineup.
How would you set the lineup?
I mean, I would totally change this lineup. I mean, I would lead off weak.
Okay. Because really?
He needs a hug. He needs a hug. You know, he needs to be needed.
Here he is, right here. This is Frank's lineup.
This guy provides energy. He can run. He can hit with power. He needs to see more fastballs at the top right lineup. Second is Cody Bellinger. Get him up there. Like you said, you want to get him more at-bats, and he's a danger threat, and he can protect Yasiel Puig. Turner, Machado, Max Muncy, Matt Kemp, Brian Dozier, Yasmal Grandal. You can mix guys, you know, whoever you're playing off the pitch
in an 8-hole. Yeah.
And this lineup will be more consistent, and they can hit the baseball. I just think, you know, you leave your hat at the door when you got a lineup so deep and tell guys you're not being punished because you're hitting 5 through 8.
Right.
It's just we have a deep lineup that can hit with anybody.
And you both hit, so it's important to know when you come to the ballpark that where you're going to be.
Exactly.
And, right? That's a comfort level for
it's
you.
It's a comfort zone, but we got a team that's this talented. You just bring them all in and just say, hey,
right.
I know it's a little uncomfortable batting 5th through 8th, but this is how stacked our lineup is, and we want this balance 1 through 8, and we're going to give any starting pitcher fits.
Well, I think that's the thing, man. They also have depth.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, like you saw Jock Peterson. Right. You can bring him off the bench, your left-handed bat. You know, you got Kike Hernandez, who can play offense
Taylor.
And defense. Taylor as well. Mm-hmm. I feel like there's a lot of things. I mean, you know, Doc Roberts has his hands full over there because there's a lot of different personalities over there
as well. They are second in runs scored in the National League, but I think a set lineup. But lately, the runs haven't been flowing as freely. So the Indians meeting with the Red Sox. He's an analyst. He has to analyze. So both of these teams with sizable division leads, they're headed towards the postseason. What's the value in this series? Let's start with the Indians for this match.
Sure. Yeah, I think it was a big series for them. You got to look at it like this. They're 18-22 against teams over 500, which means they don't play well against the good teams in the league. The one thing also, too, you got to remember, the Indians are 13 games up coming into tonight, and the Boston Red Sox are 8 games up. Mm-hmm. The one thing also on top of that is the Cleveland Indians do not play another contending team until the end of September. So that just goes to show you, these games are important for them because you never know. Like we talked about, this could be a playoff matchup moving forward, and the Indians definitely wanted to make a huge statement. Encarnacion coming off the DL. 2 bombs tonight. Probably want a cracker this way and that way.
Yep.
I mean, the Indians are feeling good right now.
I just think it was a measuring stick type of series because there's 4 great teams in the American League. You just saw 2 tonight,
yep.
And both of these teams are rounding in shape. They're playing great baseball. October is going to be dynamite.
Yep.
I just still look at this Cleveland team as a team that could upset any one of these top 3 teams. So you got to watch out for these guys, and you better not go to sleep on them because I think they're rounding in shape more than any team right now because the pitching is getting better.
Yep.
The hitters are starting to really hit, and they're still looking for guys off the bench that can help them. Cleveland is going to be a team you got to watch out for in the playoffs this year.
You got guys like Melky Cabrera, Greg Allen. Mm-hmm. Guys are stepping up in crucial spots. And obviously, we haven't seen Chris Sale pitch in this series because he's on the DL. Mm-hmm. But David Price pitching tomorrow, that's going to be interesting to see how the game shakes out tomorrow as well.
These are powerhouse clubs, and so are the Yankees. But the injuries are mounting for New York.